students, today we will talk about computer network. Observe the picture given above. What do you see? Yes, you are right. That's railways network. Do you know how the Indian railway system works? Indian Railway is the fourth largest railway network in the world in terms of size. India is a geographically vast country with a wide railway network system that connects one part of the country to another. A large number of railway stations are interconnected with each other through railway lines. Trains run on these railway lines that form a network. Like the railway network, the computers are also interconnected and together they form a computer network. In a railway network, the trains can move from one station to another using railway lines that are connected. These trains can transport passengers and goods from one station to another. Recently, Government of India also started with specialized trains known as Kisan trains to transfer agriculture products of farmers. Similarly, in a computer network, computer can send and receive information using various communication channels like wired and wireless channels. Computer network. In friendship, we often share thoughts, emotions, and things that we like with our friends. Similarly, in order to share information, two or more computers also need to be connected. A computer network consists of two or more computers that are interconnected with each other using different mediums of communication. All these computers are connected with each other in such a way that they can share information and at times hardware resources amongst each other. First, let us talk about the need for a computer network. Let's now discuss the benefits of a computer network. A computer network can prove to be highly beneficial for an organization in several ways. Given below are some of the benefits of a computer network. Sharing resources. In computer terminology, resources constitute of information or data, apps and hardware devices. Computers that are connected over a network can share these resources.
For example, in a network, there can be a single computer with a printer attached to it.
All other computers that are part of the network can use the network services of the same printer. Reducing data redundancy. Imagine that there are 100 employees working in an organization and all of them want to work on the same file. What, according to you, would be the best way of sharing the same file with all the employees at one single time? One way is to store an individual copy of the same file on all computers. This will lead to redundancy or duplication of data. The other way is to connect all the computers over a network and store a single copy of the file on a central computer so that the other connected computers can access the file as and when required. This will help in reducing duplication of data. Saves cost. We can read how different hardware resources can be shared by all the computers that are connected over a single network. This does not call for the need to buy multiple products.
For example, a single modem can serve the purpose of providing internet to many devices that are connected over a network. Like a family of 5 members can use a single car and need not buy 5 different cars.
Security. Security becomes a vital factor in securing the information that is shared by different computers over a network. This can be achieved by using various techniques like installing a firewall system and other network protection apps available in different platforms. This helps in combating data theft and phishing.
Network and its types.
Personal Area Network, PAN. It is a computer network that caters to an individual user. It is used for establishing communication among devices such as laptops, mobile phones or smartphones. This type of network is suitable for home users. PAN generally covers a range of up to around 10 meters. Wireless channels can be used for establishing a connection between different devices. We can use these networks to transfer different types of files. Local Area Network, LAN. The local area network is confined to a limited area such as a room, an office building, or a school, or a college campus. As the area covered by LAN is limited, the data transmission speed in LAN is very fast and can be easily maintained. In LAN, the computer terminals are physically connected with wires. When computer systems connect without wires in a local area network, it is called WLAN. Metropolitan Area Network, MAN. The Metropolitan Area Network is spread across a city. As compared to LAN, it covers a wider area. The computers in a MAN network can be connected through wires as well as through wireless communication mediums. ATM machines of a specific bank, installed at different locations in a city, are example of MAN. These ATM machines can share data with other ATM machines and can also share data with the central computer that is installed in the main branch of the bank. Wide Area Network, WAN.
The world that we see consists of large continents. Even the terrain of all these continents are different from each other. Thus, it is a challenging situation wherein the engineers try to develop networks that will provide uninterrupted network connectivity. One provides satellite-based communication, and the signals can penetrate remote areas, thereby providing continuous network connectivity. One provides internet connectivity through satellite communication channels. Topologies.
Network topology refers to the arrangement of various components of a network in a way that facilitates easy communication. Before you start with the arrangement of network components, it is important to define how the information will flow between these components. This is called logical topology. Second is how these components will be physically arranged. The arrangement of network components is called physical topology. Network topologies are categorized into the following basic types. Point to point. Out of all the available network topologies, this topology is very popular as it is simple to use. It is used to establish direct communication between two network components. Example, computers, routers, hub, etc. A direct link can be established using wired and wireless technologies. Bus topology.
In a human body, the spine, or what we call the backbone, supports the body's entire structure. Similarly, in a network in which all the computers are connected with the main cable, these connected computers transmit data in a single direction. Such networks form bus topology. The bus topology is widely used in places where the floor area is small. It is suitable for home, office, and shops. Just like other network topologies, this topology also has a disadvantage. The breakdown of main cable in bus topology will lead to the failure of the entire network.
Star topology. In star topology, the central server acts as a master computer or a server. Devices communicate across the network by passing data through this master computer.
In star topology, each device is connected to a server computer using a point-to-point connection.
Popular in use. In this topology, it is easy to add a new device to the network with the help of only one cable. The configuration too is simple. It is more robust than the bus topology because if a connection in the network fails, the other connections remain intact. The entire network goes down only if the central computer or hub fails. Ring topology.
In a ring topology, the computers are connected in a ring-like structure. The formation of the connected computers looks is like a circle with dots placed on it. Together, all the connected devices in this form are called a ring network. In ring network, data travels from one computer to another until it reaches its destination computer. In a ring topology, we do not need a central computer or a server to handle data. Each computer in itself works as a server computer and helps in the transmission of data. A major disadvantage of this type of network is it is difficult to add or repair a single computer while the data is passing through the network. In this type of network, if one computer stops working, the entire network goes down.
Tree topology. The tree topology is a particular type of structure where many connected network components are arranged like a tree's branches. A tree topology is a combination of a star network topology and a bus topology. Since any two nodes can have only two mutual connections, tree topology creates a natural parent and child hierarchy. In a tree topology, there can only be one connection between any two connected computers. The tree topology is frequently used to organize the computers in a large corporate network or for database-related services.
There are few disadvantages of tree topology. As compared to bus and star topology, large cabling is required. Tree network is very difficult to manage and configure. In tree topology, all the computers are connected with a hub. If the hub fails to work properly, the entire network fails.
Mesh topology. In the mesh network topology, computers are connected in an arbitrary fashion. In this type of topology, each computer can send its signal to the other computers in the network. Along with that, it also helps in retransmitting the data to other computers on the network. This topology setup allows major transmissions to be distributed even if one of the connections goes down. It is a topology commonly used for wireless networks. The overall cost of maintaining this type of network is too high. Peer-to-peer network. A peer-to-peer network is the one where a few computers of equal capacity and capabilities are connected together to use the resources available on the web. In a peer-to-peer network, there is no central server. Instead, each computer can act both as a server and a client. Client-server architecture. In a client-server network, several computers called clients or workstations are connected to the main computer called the server. A server is a computer that provides services to clients and controls access to hardware, software, and other resources. Clients are the computers that request services like data, retrieval, storage, etc. from the server. Let us quickly have a look on chapter review. Computers that are connected over the network can share resources. Computer networks help in reducing redundancy. The local area network is confined to a limited area such as a small room. The metropolitan area network is spread across a city. Wide area network connects two or more computers located in distant places. Network topology refers to the arrangement of various components of a network in a way that facilitates easy communication. In bus topology, the main cable acts as a backbone for the network. In star topology, the central server acts as a master computer or a server. Ring topologies are used in both LAN and WAN setups. A tree topology is a particular type of structure where many connected network components are arranged like a tree branches. In a client-server network, several computers called clients or workstations are connected to the main computer called the server.